fine friend. Would you like to hear a tale?
Sure thing, fella.
Well, there's a great tale of old about a war that happened around these parts. It was known as the Trojan War because it was fought between the Greeks and the Trojans. It was a 10-long-year war fought over the love of a woman. The woman's name... Come, blind friend, let's head this way. The woman's name was Helen. She was kidnapped from her husband, Menelaus, by Paris of Troy. The Greeks had vowed to Menelaus before Helen's wedding to help protect her honor at all costs. So all the Greeks were bound by this duty and honor to save Helen from Paris after she was kidnapped. Whoa. So the war began because of Helen and because of Paris. The Greeks sailed across the ocean to Troy. And there were many warriors that fought there. One such warrior was Diomedes, one of the greatest of the Greeks. And legend tells of great battle between he and the second greatest Trojan of all, Aeneas.
Aeneas, I challenge you!
You a guy, fool!
God Apollo sent a great cloud that shrouded Aeneas, and he was able to be whisked away from the sword of Diomedes, and he was spared the battle, and in fact, he was one of the few Trojans that actually survived after the war. The most tragic things that happened during the war was the quarrel that developed between the greatest Greek warrior, Achilles, and the leader of the Greeks, Agamemnon. What had happened was, Achilles in battle had won this beautiful woman, Briseis, and Agamemnon, in his greed, had taken her from Achilles to keep her for himself. Achilles, therefore, refused to fight for the Greeks anymore, for he was so greatly insulted. He just stayed in his tent while the Greeks fought, and the Trojans came upon them, and the Greeks were losing sorely. So Agamemnon, after being advised by the wise Greek Nestor, sent Odysseus as an envoy to Achilles, offering him back Briseis and many gifts.
Announcing the entrance of Diomedes and Odysseus.
Odysseus, why is it so much?
Greetings, Achilles.
Diomedes,
I come today, Odysseus, bearing a message from our chieftain Agamemnon. Here is the message.
What are you doing?
Well, the message says that Agamemnon is agreeing to deliver back to you your battle prize Briseis, which he has taken. And he's also offering many gifts, gold and wine. And as a friend, Achilles, knowing that without you the Trojans will overrun us, and we will most certainly be destroyed, I request that you fight. Sorry to hear that, Achilles. Now we will serve. Farewell.
You should fight with us.
Patroclus, my brother, good to see you.
It's good to see you too, but I bring some bad news. The Trojans have us pushed back almost to the shore. At least listen to me. You must fight.
I cannot fight. Agamemnon has offended me.
Even give you my honor.
Don't use it. Wink!
Well, my brother.
Hector! It is Achilles!
No! We fight as men!
No!
Oh!
Excuse me, sir.
What message?
Messenger boy.
Well, sir, Hector has killed Patroclus and has taken your armor from him and is dancing around. I am Achilles! Look at me, I'm Achilles!
What, messenger boy?
Patroclus is dead!
No! No! He will die!
Hector, you have killed my friend, and now you will die.
Mightiest Greek warrior killed Hector, the mightiest Trojan warrior. But Achilles knew after Hector was dead that he also was fated to die. But before his death, he had one more glorious victory. And that was over Prince Memnon of Ethiopia, who had come to join the Trojans in their fight against the Greeks.
Of Ethiopia! My gun's down!
You see, when Achilles was young, his mother, the nymph Thetis, had taken him to the river Styx in the underworld and dipped him in to make him invulnerable. But the one part she missed was his heel, upon which she held him. And that is where Paris hit him. And the mighty Achilles fell.
Paris!
Salute!
Ah!
No!
Ah!